it's been confirmed that the aliens have landed.
Hello once again, race fans, and welcome to another exciting Formula Rock highlight video. It's round number 7 of season 7 at the Diamond Ridge Speedway, a track we've never been to before. But before we get started, I'm so excited to announce the completion of the Formula Rock corporate office building complex. Yeah, we were told to go with a really expensive building company, big name, but we decided, no, let's go with someone no one's ever heard of. So we went with Bob's Construction Company and saved a ton of money. And here they are, the two buildings. The left one is the corporate executive offices, and the right one is the competition offices. We're going to be moving in the morning. I'm just looking forward to this. It's so exciting at least the right building is still standing. Okay, lovely. Oh well, the money for that office complex was donated by private investors, so it doesn't bother me. Anyway, pole position was set by Randy R3 with a 201.391, his second pole of the season. It's 74 laps of green flag racing. Well, we hope green flag racing. Randy R3 outqualified Taz Jr. 8 there on the outside of front row by just 0.2 of a second. It was very close. As the field comes down the front straight, it's a 5-cornered oval track. We are racing 74 laps, like I said. Beautiful, exciting action. You're now looking at number 9, Prez, who started on the inside of the second row, had his hand operated on earlier in the week, for he severed the tendon between his thumb and wrist, but he's out on the track with a cast on, still trying to compete. You're looking at number 15, DVD, racing behind number 58, Mark B, with Tucson 4 in there as well. On the opening lap through the 5-cornered oval track, as we said before, one corner, extremely difficult, labeled the go straight to hell corner by that driver right there, number 58, Mark B, which I think is going to stick probably forever. All right, he's following Prez in the opening laps, got DBD in there. The field is racing. It's exciting. And we finally see, just so you know, that front car there in this pack, that's number 32, Rock Craven, and we actually see him in his right car for the first time ever in a Formula Rock highlight video. That's Lance Mofanoop running right behind him. Back up front, Randy R3 with the lead. Prez is going low, has Mark B going with him. DBD trying to decide who he's going to go with. Diving into the corner, he decides to go low. Prez, the man with the cast, out front with Mark B now in second place in the very early stages of this event. At this track, as I said, we've never raced on before. Now you know. Tucson 4 racing side by side with Taz Jr. 8. Randy R3 right in front of him. This is the battle for the top 5 or 6 guys. Great racing. This track was nice and wide open. Lots of room to move and pass and all sorts of stuff. You're looking at number 68. That's Johnny Kaz in the Catmobile. Running well on the racetrack. Started about 8th. And that's in the blindingly bright yellow car. Orange car. That'll piss him off. Orange car, Armalat, on the track. All right. Prez is led, but Mark P's tired of that. He wants the lead. Got DBD and Randy R3 pushing him through. Tucson 4 in there as well. Prez is getting freight trained backward, which is what happens on these oval tracks. To about 5th. Ooh, Taz Jr. 8 trying to dive down underneath as well. He does so. It's side by side. Back up front, number 58 in the Amber Bach ride. Mark B showing the way through the high banks. I think this is the go straight to hell corner, as a matter of fact. Very tricky. Almost a 180 degree corner. Oh no, that was just turn 5. Never mind. Let's see if we can see it. This is the kink. Turn 1 is just sort of a kink. You dive underneath. There you go. Will we show it? They're heading towards that go straight to hell corner. They're entering it, but I think the clip's going to end. No, they're in the... This is the corner. The go straight to hell corner. What happens is the centrifugal force of your car wants to pull the car all the way out to the wall, and you'll see many guys banging that wall in this race tonight. As DBD Prez, nice evasive move by Armalat as DBD bounces off the bottom. Everybody keeps racing. You're looking at number 327, Camaro guy 327, behind Armalat in that blindingly orange car with... That's Johnny Caz behind him. Johnny Caz tucks in behind, and they're making a pass. Number 17, Snake Oil, on the track, racing with Dixie Dan, Armalat, bunch of guys in there. Great drafting track. As I said, plenty of room for racing. Very exciting. Now you know. On the track, number 53, Row Warrior in the AC Delco ride. A little bit off pace. Must have got a bad start. Not really sure, but he's lost the draft in this early stages of the event, but he is soldiering on anyway. Behind him, we have Crazy Marv in the Droopers ride, number 78, in that green and blue car. He's got Rock Craven diving underneath him, staying nice and wide. Letting him go. Ooh, that's the corner. That's to go straight to hill corner. He brushes the wall, but he's okay. But that allows Lance Mofo Noob to suck up and make the... Not suck up, but I mean his car. Well, you know the drafting thing. Anyway, back up front, Randy R3 in the lead. Back into second place from his front row starting position, Taz Jr. 8. As the race continues, Mark B in third. Looks like Tucson 4 looking for a way by, has Prez pushing him through, dropping Mark B. Ooh, Mark B having a little connection issue at this event, but he continues. Very important. Alrighty then, back to racing. Well, we're still racing. You're looking at Camaro guy. He's side by side with Taz Jr. Johnny Caz. Okay, rein it in. Get it back together. Get to discussing the racing. There's that blindingly orange car. The Z-Max ride of Armalat racing side by side with Snake Oil. These guys have done that many times in the past. Now, a lot of guys don't know this. The number 15 car driven by DBD, his team has put together a Nextel Cup ride for 2007. They have one car, and the plan for their team is as long as that car is healthy and able to race... Oh, he smacks the wall there in the go straight to hell corner. Anyway, as long as that car is healthy and happy, they're going to run some races. We have some footage from his recent test, and this is DBD testing that car. Ow. I guess DBD will be racing Formula Rock. Craftsman Trucks. So much for 2007. All right. Taz Jr. 8. Drafting with Randy R3. This is the top three spots. Tucson 4 as well. They've kind of got a bit of a gap. Not enough to protect it, but anyway. You're looking at number 53, Row Warrior, DBD, after smacking the wall and they go straight to hill corner, drop back a few positions, got a little bit of damage on that car, working with Row Warrior to stay on the lead lap. He's not that far back, but just working with Row Warrior. And Dixie Dan in the Tennessee Volunteers ride, going underneath Armalat. It's a side-by-side racing action. Both drivers working. It looks like Dixie Dan's going to pull off the pass after all. Now you know. Camaro guy 327 sick on this night. In fact, he's been sick for over a week. Oh, and he clobbers the wall coming out of the go straight to hell corner. That car is going to have some damage. And about a lap later, Armalat, same corner, the go straight to hell corner. You can see the car pushing out. Oh, clobbers that wall as well. Ooh, Snake Oil goes by. And now Armalat has some fairly significant damage as well. Meanwhile, back up front, Tucson 4 going for the lead, takes it right at the start-finish line. That's 5 bonus points for him. Tucson 4, one of those drivers who's deserved a win a number of times, still waiting for his first win in Formula Rock. Should happen at any time. Mark B drafting with Tucson 4 up into second place is Prez, the cast man, working by. There he is in third, one arm in that thing around the racetrack. All right then, Prez now. Oh, we got almost three wide. This is the straight to hell corner. Tucson 4 and Prez both in the wall. Somebody got in the back of Tucson 4. Let's take a look at that again. Both cars are going to slow up because they smacked the wall. That's going to be, Taz Jr. 8 just taps him. I think everybody continues, but that's going to drop Taz off the draft a little bit. Armalat now with damage is dropped behind Dixie Dan and Row Warrior as well. Row Warrior staying wide, giving plenty of room, but he's got the damage. Armalat has the damage. So does DBD, as now you know. Back up front, Mark B with the lead, Randy R3 wants the lead, Johnny Caz pushing R3 through with the draft. Randy R3 back in the lead. Am I making sense? Because it seems like I'm stumbling over my words a lot tonight. But anyway, we will continue. Rock Craven coming off the straight to hell corners, drifting out into that gray, bam, smacks the wall. And that doesn't look bad on the replay, but that's some serious damage. He's the first car now in for green flag pit stops. Ooh, and Clopper's the wall entering the pits as well. Ouch. Couple laps later, Randy R3 is going in the pits as the leader. Johnny Kaz outbreaks Randy R3 into the pit lane. Randy R3 a little too cautious. Johnny Kaz taking advantage of it and takes the lead. Well, even though they're not around the track. The actual leader now, Mark B, of course, who has not pitted yet, picks up another lap out front. We've gone about 23 laps now. Green flag racing. Tucson 4 also stayed out, going another lap. Meanwhile, there's Johnny Kaz coming out of his pits. Randy R3 right there, and Johnny Kaz definitely beats Randy R3 back on the racetrack as Snake Oil comes along as well. But of course, a lap or two later, Mark B is in the pits, as is Tucson 4. But I don't understand this. Tucson 4 is only in his pits for about 4 or 5 seconds, not enough time to pick up any fuel. And as he's coming out of the pits, the car coughs, ran out of fuel. Not sure what happened with his pits, but Tucson 4 not only out of fuel, but out of the race as well. That's a very weird pit right there. Not sure what happened. And then a couple of Taz Jr. 8 runs out of fuel as we get a yellow flag. I'm not sure if it was Tucson 4 or whatever, but look at Camaro guy pushing Taz Jr. 8 all the way back to the pits. We picked up a yellow flag that said debris on the racetrack. Not sure what it was. Might have been the dead car of Tucson 4 or Taz running out of fuel. Anyway, everything gets cleaned up. We're going back to green flag racing. Johnny Kaz has the lead. You'll get a nice close-up view of his car right about here. There he is coming into turn one in the Caterpillar ride. The battle for second place. Snake Oil has it. Mark B was in third. Randy R3 started fourth. DBD in fifth. The battle now between second, third, and fourth on the racetrack as Randy R3 dives down low, putting the move on Mark B for third spot. Johnny Kaz out front. Snake Oil in second as the race continues on. A little farther back, Rock Craven's a lap down now. I believe DBD is as well. I'm not sure. I could be wrong there. Anyway, Armalat going past down low. I know DBD had to get quite a bit of damage repaired. So did Armalat, though. Back up front, Randy R3 diving low underneath Johnny Kaz. This is the fight for the lead. Snake Oil will dive across the track, tuck in behind Randy R3, and pick up second spot as the field continues on its way. And as I said before, 74 laps of exciting racing action. All right, then. Dixie Dan going by Mark B as well, moving into the top five now. Dixie Dan having a good, solid race here. Ooh, DBD clobbers the wall again, coming through the go straight to the hell corner. Ow. All right, anyway, Dixie Dan moving by, coming up behind Johnny Kaz now. A little farther back, that's Prez, who's now a lap down as well, racing with Row Warrior, who is also a lap down, as I recall. All right, Rock Craven again, the straight-to-hill corner. Ooh, man, it's so easy to drift out on that corner. You have to really be on your toes to keep that from happening. A lot of different drivers picking up some damage with that corner. Meanwhile, Lance Mofonoop and, ooh, Crazy Marv, who taps the wall just a little bit as well. Okay, Taz Jr. 8 on the track. He's running about 10th. Lost a lot of time with that run out of fuel bit, but he's still on the lead lap, just doesn't have anybody to draft with. Back up front, Johnny Kaz diving underneath the leader, Randy R3, who just keeps it off the wall. Mark B going with Johnny Kaz, both drivers pushing through. Looks like Snake Oil will tuck in there as well. Johnny Kaz back out front. Right behind Snake Oil now, Dixie Dan, who's moved into the top five. I think I already said that, but now you can see clearly he is in the top five. Thank you very much. Mark B now, tired of being second, has had serious connection problems, but he is getting the lead despite the fact that he just occasionally disappears from the racetrack. All right, then. The Dayglow car of Armalat with DBD, both cars having some more damage on their track, working together, staying on the lead lap, I think. I can't remember. I'm sorry. If DBD's a lap down, my fault. What can I tell you? I can't remember. Randy R3 now. It's time for a second round of green flag pit stops. Pulls in out of second place. Nobody goes with him. That's going to hurt him coming out of the pits with no drafting partner. Thanks a lot. All right, then. Mark B stays out with Johnny Kaz. I believe Dixie Dan will be right behind them as well as Snake Oil. That'll be your top four. But a couple laps later, Johnny Kaz and Dixie Dan pit together. And Randy R3 is coming out of the pits as those guys are, of course, coming in. Mark B, then a lap later, comes in on his own. We've got a number of cars in the pits by this stage. Road Warrior comes out, gets on the white line, is going to lose it on the grass, slide across the infield. Ooh, clobber that inside wall. Keeps it going, though, so no yellow flag. After all pit stop shakeout, it's Johnny Kaz and Snake Oil working together in the draft with a pretty good size 4 or 5 second lead over this driver, number 3, Randy R3, with no drafting partner. So he's losing quite a bit of time per lap, just praying for a yellow flag. Meanwhile, behind Randy R3, Dixie Dan in fourth, also running by himself without a drafting partner, falling behind as well. And then behind them, Armalat and Mark P actually hooked up together. These guys are drafting together, but they've got a long way to go to close up on the other guys. But now you make your own call. This happens exactly at the same time. First Road Warrior trying to keep it off the wall is going to lose it, smack the wall hard, almost. Well, no, he does get up on his head. Ooh, and he's clobbered by Lance Mofonoop. Now this may have run out the yellow, not really sure. It's either this or at exactly the same time. Sickly driver, Camaro guy 327, going into the straight-to-hell corner, bops the bottom. Car's going to get tail happy and clobber the crash wall. Big time on his head. He'll slide for about 400 or 500 yards on his head, finally rolling over onto his tires right about here. One of those two simultaneous crashes brings out the yellow. That will allow Prez, who was a lap down, to get the lucky dog and be back on the lead lap. That allows also all the drivers without drafting partners to close right back up. Johnny Kaz brings him down for the green with Snake Oil second, Randy R3 third, Dixie Dan fourth, and Armalat in fifth. We are green flag racing once again here at Diamond Ridge. Randy R3 moments later ducks low with Mark B's help, dives past Snake Oil into second place, and is looking to put a move on the leader, but that's not going to work. At least not at this stage, but, you know, a lap later. R3 apparently enjoying this track. Dives low under Johnny Kaz, taking the lead back again. And continuing on the exciting racing action with Mark B. I can't tell. I think Mark B does, yes, in fact, pass Johnny Kaz for second place. Dropping Johnny Kaz in third. Looks like Dixie Dan trying to get into third. That's Armalat trying to drop Johnny Kaz to fourth. Hey, nobody's perfect. All right, Dixie Dan working with Armalat, trying to freight train Johnny Kaz towards the back. DBD's up in there with Snake Oil as well. As we are continuing on our way through straight to hell corner. Looks like no one's going straight to hell this time through, though. Very nice. GT, thanks to that yellow flag, is now back in the racing action. He never did drop a lap down. Despite running out of fuel, he's racing now with Prez, who is back on the lead lap. This is the battle for seventh place. Both drivers back in this event. A little farther back, having lost the draft, though, Crazy Marv just looking for another yellow to close back in. All right, back in the event. Dixie Dan's diving low. Snake Oil's trying to tuck back in, but taps the back of his car, slams the wall, collects DBD, and we have a pretty big accident. Also collects the cast man, Prez. Pretty big accident. That's going to bring out the yellows. Look at that again. DBD, the innocent victim here. Snake Oil's trying to tuck back in, but just misjudges that a slightly. DBD, big time on his head. Going to flip, and then as he's trying to get it straightened out, taps the wall, but Crazy Marv just clobbers DBD. Huge spiraling crash for DBD in the second hit. Amazingly, this car continues at all. Let's take a look at that from on board with Prez. As he's one-armed around the track, the crash happens up ahead. You got cars lifting off. All of a sudden, Snake Oil, no place to go. Fortunately, Prez doesn't pick up any serious damage. And after the yellow flag stint, before that happens, Dixie Dan will stay out and pick up 5 bonus points for leading that particular lap right there. However, the rest of the field is into the pits, everybody making their final pit stop. All right, we're getting down into the late stages of the event. It's Mark B with the lead, Randy R3 second, Armalat third. That's Crazy Marv down low, he's lapped down. The green flag is out, we are racing. You're going to get a nice view of Mark B's car up close and personal. There it is, the Amperbach ride. Very nice. The field is coming down into turn one. Johnny Kaz already diving low under Armalat, who has damage. Mark B first, R3 second, Johnny Kaz third. We have Dixie Dan, who's still in the event, racing. Ooh, man, he's tail happy through the straight to hell corner, but doesn't crash. Coming down the back straight into another corner. I forget which corner this is. Ooh, Randy R3 gets down on the white, almost loses it. Johnny Kaz goes around the outside. A nice outside pass by Johnny Kaz, who was thinking that one through. Saves what could have been an accident and moves into second place as well, dropping the squirrely number 3 car back to third place. Perez, who was involved in that crash, obviously has no damage. He is running in the top six racing GT. All right, back up front, Randy R3 diving low under Mark B yet again and is going to take the lead through the turn one kink. Well, I think he does. They're certainly racing side by side as they come into the straight to hell corner. Don't want to be on the outside in the straight to hell corner. You have no chance. You have to back off to keep them slapping the wall. And Randy R3, along with Johnny Kaz, are going to go by. You're on board with the glaringly orange car of Armalat, who is in fourth place watching the three cars battle up front. As we are heading through turns four, or three and four, I guess. And that would be turn five up ahead. All right, this is the battle for sixth place. Perez and Taz Jr. 8. Close dicing, but great side-by-side racing. That's awesome. All right, then, a little farther back. Snake Oil was involved in that big wreck, but his car is damaged and off pace, but he's still soldiering on. Back into the race for the lead. Mark B in second place, going by Johnny Kaz. Armalat pushing him through. Taz Jr. 8. I don't know why I keep wanting to call him GT Baker tonight, but it's Taz Jr. 8 working with Johnny Kaz. All right, then. Looks like Perez has dropped off the graph there a little bit. Davey D on the flat. Car's going to go head-on into the crash wall. Big-time upside-downer. Davey D thinking quickly, though, as the car comes to a stop, quickly ejects himself from the race right here and apparently is able to avoid a yellow flag because a yellow does not come out as Armalat clobbers the wall once again, adding just a little bit more damage to that car, which allows Prez to close back up and have some drafting help again, working his way back to the front group. Randy R3 with the lead. We are now, he knows he's got to lead the end of this lap because once he crosses the line, there will be 10 laps to go. And once you have 10 laps to go, the lead car can run anywhere he wants to on the track and does not have to stay outside on the outside line, per Formula Rock rules. And as you can see, riding on board with Mark B, R3 is starting to protect that lower line now. With less than 10 laps to go, it's going to be a cat and mouse game. Once the rules lifted with 10 laps to go, the driver up front can run it. In fact, any driver can run his car wherever he wants to, so long as he doesn't wreck anybody. Three wide there, coming through one of the corners. Randy R3 now thinks he has a shot at the victory and is protecting that inside line, so Johnny Kaz and Mark B are beginning to work together, trying to find another way past. This will get interesting. Meanwhile, besides this battle between these three cars, we've got this battle for 4th, 5th, and 6th between Armalat, Prez, and Taz Jr. 8. It's setting up for a wild finish, people. A little farther back, the damaged car of Snake Oil is running with Dixie Dan. That's Rock Craven up ahead, but he's a lap down. So the battle continues up front. Randy R3 with the lead. As they come up on the lap car of Lance Mofon, who could have got dicey, but all three cars will get through without incident and without positions changing. Although it looks like Mark B has a run. Anyway, Randy R3 has the lead. You're on board with Johnny Kaz. It's coming down to the end. Drivers jockeying for position as the laps are running out. Looking out the back of our three cars, you can see that Mark B and Johnny Kaz are trying to work together to figure out a way by. It's going to be a barn burner of a finish. And look at the battle for fourth. These guys are side by side and nose to tail. It's going to be a wild finish, unfortunately, with five laps to go. Rock Craven gets into the wall. Snake Oil dives to the bottom, trying to put a pass on Prez and Taz Jr. 8, but hits the bottom. The car's going to go up the track, tag the wall. Rock Craven will not be able to avoid his slowing car, hit him in the back, and that's going to set off this wild crash for Snake Oil. Sure, Johnny Kaz held the record for the worst crash of Season 7 at the Figure 8 race at Mission earlier in the season, in fact, race number 1, but I don't know, folks. Take a look at Snake Oil. This might be a worse crash. That is a vicious, vicious accident for Snake Oil. And he will be out of the race with a busted gearbox with a couple of laps to go. We're racing back to the line. This is basically it with about four laps to go. Randy R3 knows he's got to stay ahead of Johnny Kaz just until here. And that's basically the race right there. We are going to putt around under yellow. So, taking fifth place under yellow, Prez, that's Taz Jr. 8 behind him who will be sixth. Prez, with a cast on, having just had an operation a few days earlier, is going to bring that American flag right home with an impressive fifth, cast and all. Coming home fourth, despite some pretty heavy damage, our current reigning champion, number 45, Armalat, actually drives a pretty good race considering the damage to hold everybody off and bag fourth place. driving an excellent drive. The Amber Buck driver, number 58, Mark B., an excellent run. Didn't get involved in any crashes. Didn't get involved really in anything. Stayed in the front group all day. Mark B., an outstanding third place for him. Bringing it home in the runner-up spot. Says he doesn't like ovals, but Johnny Kaz was on the gas this entire event. A very good drive for Johnny Kaz. Excellent run. Something to be proud of. Brings that ride home in second place. But bagging his third victory of the season, 14th career. Number three, Randy R3, opens up a bit of a point lead to 53 and takes the victory in our inaugural run at the Diamond Ridge track. So from another view, here's your final race results. Now we're taking the following week off to celebrate Christmas. So Merry Christmas to all of you guys and your families and loved ones. And we'll see y'all the following week at OWR Lakeside. Now, you know, Perez was told not to ride his motorcycle and to stay off it for a few weeks while he has his cast on, but he's a Formula Rock driver, and Formula Rock drivers, we're rebels. We do what we want. And so here's a shot of Perez leaving the pits after the race.
Do you have any idea what I'm talking about? Because frankly, I don't have a clue.